What's up, guys? This is Alan. In today's episode, I'm going to be telling you everything you need to know in order to successfully grow your own ice cream bean tree. This is a tropical tree, extremely rare. You probably have never heard of it before, but guess what? If you like beans, you're going to like the ice cream bean tree. The fruit looks just the same, and surprisingly, it's one of the easiest plants to grow here in the desert. But there are a few key things that you need to understand before you even start growing your own. So with that said, let's go ahead and get started. All right, ice cream bean tree. Like I said, one of the easiest trees to grow in the desert. I've had mine trees for the past few years, and I can tell you, I have learned so much about it. So let's talk about the history of my tree real quick before we get into the specifics of the growing conditions for this plant. So I have two trees in the ground. When I first put it in the ground, I really didn't know much about growing this plant. And usually when growing tropical plants, you assume they are very complicated. You need special everything and you need to shelter them, right? So that's the main reason why I planted this one here in the ground. Believe it or not, this plant right here is one of the oldest ones that I have in the ground out of all the trees in the property. And the only reason it's still in here is simply because, well, it grew so slow and it really didn't take off until some of the branches grew into the sun over there. But it's too shaded. Yes, it's too shaded. And that's the reason why it looks so small. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the other one. All right, guys, so the second one, it's in this mess right here. My passion fruit vine is growing all the way around it, so it's weighing it down. Now, back in the day, I had a lemon tree in here, and it was super huge, and my ice cream bean tree was back there, and this wasn't here, that wasn't there, so it was getting a decent amount of sun, and that brings us to the sun requirements. Ice cream bean trees require full sun anywhere in the United States, even here in the desert. If you keep them in the shade, they are going to grow a lot slower. And that's the only reason why the other tree underneath the pine trees is that small. But surprisingly, it actually survived longer than this one right here. This one right here actually grew like 10, 15 feet tall the first year, but frost got to it. And that brings us to the winter care. Ice cream bean trees in my area are frost sensitive. They can tolerate cold temperatures. This tree that I have in the ground actually took frost and it tolerated 19 degree ambient temperature. Yes, that happened about 4 years ago and the tree died back to about 2 feet in the ground. But you can see here's the tree, and the reason why it took forever to grow back is, for one, it had to recover from all that damage, because at the time that it took frost damage, it died back to about 2 feet in the ground. And then in that time, I was watering my trees like they're supposed to get water, and my lemon tree grew over the ice cream bean tree, shading it. But you can see the tree is here, and since I cut back my lemon tree, actually I dug it up and gave it to somebody else, my ice cream bean tree started growing. You can see the tree is growing in there, and I got branches. All the way up here, growing through the passion fruit vine. Why don't I cut it back? Well, winter is coming, and this passion fruit vine, even though it's weighing the tree down, it's gonna frost protect my ice cream bean tree. So let's talk about the root system of this plant. The root system of ice cream bean trees is a taproot system. Yes. It doesn't really have that many lateral roots. It's mainly taproot, and they go straight down in the ground. This is the reason why these trees do not do well in containers. You can grow them in containers, but they're never gonna get any decent size in a container. It's just not worth it. If you want your ice cream tree, bean tree to grow, you need to stick it in the ground. Let's talk about the tree structure. This is an actual tree. It has an upright canopy, and it will get, in tropical areas, you can expect this tree to get, I would say, between 25 to about 35, 40 feet tall. In non-tropical areas, it's still gonna get that tall, believe it or not. Now, if you keep it too shaded, like this one right here, it's gonna start growing lateral branches, trying to reach the sun, and that's the main reason why this one over here, it's really wide instead of tall on top of being And the reason for this is because it was too shaded. This one, when it got too cold, it did not suffer frost damage that year, but being in the shade, it stunted the tree until it was able to reach the sun over there. Let's talk about the growth rate. The growth rate of this tree is very fast. If you ever grew moringa in the past or a neem tree in the past, this tree grows almost just as fast as those plants. Once rooted in the ground, it will grow very quickly. I'm talking about several feet in a single year. Fruiting and flowering. Let's talk about fruiting and flowering, guys. So this tree is self-fertile, so you only need one tree to actually get fruits. Most of the ice cream bean trees sold out there are gonna be grown from seeds. If you have a seedling, it will take easily over 5 years before you start seeing flowers. And getting fruits is not that easy. Stick to the end and you will find out why. The tree normally flowers late spring and the fruits ripen through the summer, and usually you pick them late summer, early fall. Let's talk about watering. How do you water an ice cream bean tree? Well, if you're planting in a container, like this little guys right here, these are ice cream bean trees, and you can see the roots are all the way on the bottom. But this tree is right here, usually I water right now twice daily, because twice daily they're drying out 50%. So if your ice cream bean tree is in a container, follow the 50% rule. That rule works on most plants out there. Now, if your tree is in the ground, the first year in the ground, just follow my finger method. Link in the description for a video where I explain in details how to water your trees the first year in the ground. But once the tree is older, you want to start deep watering. Remember, this has a taproot system, and the older the tree gets, the deeper the roots go into the ground, and that is where it wants to drink the water. Depending on your soil drainage, you may have to deep water for a very long time to allow the water to soak into the ground. Fertilization. Okay guys, so in containers I use the same fertilizer for all my plants, nothing special. It's just a slow release fertilizer. You can see the picture on the screen if you wanna use the same thing I use. Like I said, nothing special. If you find another fertilizer that releases, that is a slow release fertilizer, it will work just the same. Now in the ground, guys, to be honest, I don't do really much in here. I do get mulching here. There's a lot of life in the soil. They eat all this organic material, they poop, and then that feeds my plant over time. But I have never used any special fertilizers in here. I have never used anything special. Let's talk about container growing, guys. So this ice cream bean tree right here, it got left outside, so it took some frost damage. I thought it was dead, but it actually came back, as you can see. So can you grow ice cream bean trees in containers? Yeah, of course you can grow in containers. But the problem is, it will never fruit in a container. And it will never get any decent size in a container, simply because of the taproot system. So if you want to propagate your ice cream bean trees, you can go ahead and do that. You want to grow it for a little while in a container. But if you want true potential out of this tree, you need to stick it in the ground. And that brings us to my personal growing tips. Remember earlier I told you there are some key things you need to understand about this tree? Well, I'm about to tell you that. So this tree will only grow when the night temperatures are hot. If your day temperatures are hot and your night temperatures are cold, guess what? This tree is not going to grow. So if you have an ice cream bean tree and it's not growing for you, well, two reasons. One, it's too cold. Two, you probably have it in a container and it needs to be planted in the ground for the tree to start growing. Tip number two, if you want to propagate this tree, extremely easy to do. Very easy. But the key is, do it during the summer months only, unless you can provide artificial heat, like a heat mat. And on top of that, you need fresh seeds. That's the key. If you try propagating this tree in the past and you failed, well, you did not have enough heat, or your seeds were not fresh. Yes, they need to be fresh, like within, as I would say, a few weeks old. Because what usually happens is, if they dry, they're not going to germinate. Or if they stay too wet, they will actually rot. So this is the main reason why I propagate this tree during the summer months only, because that is the only time that actually I'm able to get fresh seeds. Where do I get my seeds from? Well, I can tell you there are no local fruiting trees in my area. It's just never going to happen. Never. I'm in the desert. The desert is the worst place for fruit production. Can I grow a lot of tropical plants? Yes. Can I grow fruits? Can I keep them on the trees until they're fully ripe? For most trees, no. The oldest tree that I actually seen in person here in my area is about 17 years old. And the guy that I talked to told me his tree started fruiting at 7 years old. But since the tree actually started flowering, he has never been able to get fruits to fully ripen on the tree throughout the summer. And the reason for that is because my temperatures here in the summer are extreme, and this tree just does not like it. So what usually happens to his tree every summer is they drop all the flowers and all the fruits, and in all these years, he hasn't been able to get a single fruit to fully ripen here in the desert. So if you want to grow this tree, keep that in mind. It's a really nice shade tree if you can keep the frost away from it. And if you get fruits, great. If you don't, well, at least you can brag to your friends that you have an ice cream bean tree. I believe I told you everything that I know about growing this tree, and everything that I said in this video, it's actually personal experience. I learned the hard way over the years just to teach it to you. So if you appreciate it, don't forget to like the video. If you have any questions, don't forget to comment below. And as always, I will see you next time.